हेलो व्यूअर्स, इन दिस लेक्चर आई एम गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट द नियो क्लासिकल पोएट्री। नियो क्लासिकल पोएट्री एज्यूम्स ट्रिमेंडस इंपॉर्टेंस इन द हिस्ट्री ऑफ इंग्लिश पोएट्री। द वर्ड नियो क्लासिकल comes from the Greek word neos. Neos means young or new. Classical means the classical masters of Greek and Rome. Thus, classical neoclassical poetry refers to the poetry of a group of poets who modeled their poetry, who wrote their poetry after the Greek and Roman writers. They thought Virgil, Horace, Homer as their models. Therefore, the English poetry of this period is called neoclassical poetry. The neoclassical poetry covers the period of 1660 to 1700. The English poetry from 1660 to 1700 is classified, known, called as the neoclassical poetry. Among the neoclassical poets are John Dryden, Alexander Pope, and others. Neoclassical poetry is referred to by different phrases such as neoclassical poetry, the Augustan age, the age of reason, and vice versa. The first and foremost poet of this movement, of this school known as school of neoclassical poetry is John Dryden. John Dryden was a man of letters. He was a great scholar. He read different subjects. He had vast knowledge of different literature. Dryden wrote masterpieces. These include Macfleckno in 1682, The Medal in 1682. His most famous poem is Absalomen and Achitophel, which came in 1681. Apart from these poems, he penned Enas Mirabilis in 1667, Religio Lysi in 1682, The Hind and the Panther in 1687, एन किलिंग्रीव इन 1686, अलेक्जेंडर्स फीस्ट इन 1697, टू माई ऑनर्ड किंग्समैन इन 1700, दीज आर द ग्रेट लिटरेरी प्रोडक्शंस ऑफ जॉन ड्राइडन. मैक फ्लेक्नो इज अ लिटरेरी सेटायर. इन मैक फ्लेक्नो द पोएट सेटराइजेज टॉमस सैडवेल. टॉमस सैडवेल इज अ पोएट ऑफ मिनिएचर. सो जॉन ड्राइडन सेटराइजेज टॉमस सैडवेल बिकॉज सैडवेल वॉज नॉट एट गुड टर्म्स विथ जॉन ड्राइडन. अपार्ट फ्रॉम मैकबेथ, मैक फ्लेक्नो इज रिटन इन अ हीरोइक मैनर. इट इज कंपोज्ड इन हीरोइक कॉपलेट. द बिगिनिंग ऑफ मैक फ्लेक्नो इज All human things are subject to decay. All human things are subject to decay. When fate summons monarchs must obey. The poem begins as an epic. This is because the neoclassical poets followed the pattern of the Greek poets. The Roman poets like Virgil, Horace and Homer. His another political satire is Absalom and Achitophel. In this poem, John Dryden satirizes his political rivals in England. Thus, John Dryden set the trend of writing neoclassical poetry. The second in line is Alexander Pope. Alexander Pope was a great neoclassical poet. He was very weak. He was diseased from childhood. He suffered from many illness. He was dwarf and short enough. Due to the social circumstances, Alexander Pope became the greatest satirist in English literature. Alexander Pope wrote Essay on Criticism, The Rap of the Lock, The Dunciad, The Essay on Man, and 4 moral essays, Epistle to Dr. Arbuthnot. Alexander Pope also translated many works of Homer into English. The Rap of the Lock is a great satire. It is a great political satire as well as literary satire. Alexander Pope perfects heroic couplet which was started by John Dryden. The next poet who followed the neoclassicism is Samuel Johnson. Samuel Johnson wrote only a few poems, but they are all masterpieces. On Daffodils came in 1724, written in heroic quatrains. His other important poems include London in 1784, The Vanity of Human Visage in 1749. T.S. Eliot studied and reviewed and evaluated his poetry in 1930 and said that Samuel Johnson was a great poet in English. Neoclassical poets in the age of Johnson, there were some poets which deserve mention, like Robert Burns, William Cowper, Thomas Percy, and others. Now, let me talk about some of the important characteristics and features of the neoclassical poetry. Number one, neoclassical poetry has more emphasis on rationalism, reason and intellect are the important things in the neoclassical poetry. They take reasoning, reason and intellect to be the important tools of poetry. In their poetry, they imitate Virgil, Homer, and Horace, the classical masters, the classical poets. Number two, a scholarly allusions. The neoclassicists made use of a scholarly allusions. They drew allusions from the Greek and Roman poets such as Virgil, Homer, and Horatio. Didacticism. The neoclassical poetry is characterized by didacticism. It is didactic poetry. The poets talks about things that are moral, that are ethical, and that are based on set of rules. Realism. Neoclassical poets were very close to realism. They didn't like the emotions, feelings, passions like the romantic poets of the Elizabethan period, Elizabethan age. The Elizabethan age expressed, Elizabethan poets expressed their passion, feelings, emotions in their poetry. The neoclassicists reacted against it and they based their poetry on realism, reason, and intellect. The next characteristic of neoclassical poetry is heroic poetry. The poetry tends to be heroic. The poets satirize the things of society in a very heroic manner. The poem has the treatment of epic, just as I cited earlier. MacFlecknoe starts as all human things are subject to decay, When fate summons, monarchs must obey. The poets start their poetry. The poets have the treatment of their poetry as an epical poem, as an epic. So, heroic poetry, heroic poetry is the important, one of the important features of neoclassical poetry. Next, objectivity. The neoclassical poets were objective in outlook. Unlike the romanticist of the Elizabethan age, the neoclassical poets looked at things objectively. They were not subjective in their outlook like the romantic poets of the Elizabethan age. They avoided giving vent to their feelings. Rather, they dwelt upon miseries, hardships, and problems of the people around them. The poetic diction. The neoclassical poetry is characterized by poetic diction. It is restrained, concrete, color, sober color, and rigid, unlike the romantic poets of the Elizabethan age. Neoclassicists were of the view that decorum, a specific style, and mannerism are the vital elements of poetry. To conclude, neoclassical poetry is a tremendous kind of poetry. The neoclassical poetry has tremendous importance in the history of English poetry. I think the neoclassical poetry must be clear to the viewer, to the students, to the learners. Thanks.